मैडम छे
Respected Regional Director Dorothy Madam, NAC PhD member Professor D. Sri Ramalalu, Dean Osmania University, Hyderabad, my colleagues from Regional Centre Cochin, Dr. Jalja Kumari, Madam, Vijay Raghavan Sir, and my other staff members and the coordinators of various LSEs who are present here, and Jyoti Sir, Head of the Regional Evaluation Division, a very warm welcome to each one of you for this interaction with our NAC PA team member. So I first of all request our regional director Dr. J.S. Dorothy Madam to warmly welcome our NAC PA team member Professor D. C. Ramalalu.
Good morning, friends. It gives me pleasure to welcome sir as an expert committee for observation related to the NAC activities, accreditation of Indira Gandhi National Open University, Regional Centre Cochin, as one of the parameters as matrices listed out by the NAC. Sir is an expert in the field of management studies, and it is not the first time he has visited Cochin. He is accustomed with the whole state of Kerala. By being an examiner, by being an editorial board for the journals associated with management studies. And sir, to you I present all our representatives from the local study centers, our regional evaluation center deputy registrar, Dr. Prema, who is the regional model study center, regional center model study center, which is existing in the campus, And the local study center's head coordinator and program in charge have been with us. So I welcome each one of you to this session of how being a part of where we are being certified for the accreditation process. And we also thank the host institution behind each one of you for representing us in the field, the various fields, in the various geographical location. And we also take this opportunity to thank. And we commit this day's proceedings to the hand of the Almighty God. Always this, I believe that the how much ever we prepare, the victory comes from the Lord. I look forward for that. Thank you and welcome to this session once again.
Thank you, Dorothy Madam, for your kind words. Now I request our NAC PhD member, Professor D. Ramanulu, Dean, Osmania University, Hyderabad, to kindly address all of you.
Yeah, good morning. Good morning to everybody. Dr. J.S. Dorothy Madam, Regional Director, Regional Center for Chile. And Dr. Jay Kumari and all the respective dignitaries in the respective centers. In our state we call that coordinators like that. So once again very very good morning. And here we are all colleagues, you already know that. To be frank, I am also more interested that side already. But today that because of the NAC they sent me, so I came as an observer here and I have to give the report to them, that is only that. Because most of all we learn or like that teaching is the most important. Our bread and butter from the teaching and we enjoy the teaching, that is the most important. So, and here my limitation is that because I don't want to speak more, because just observation and I have to give the report. Yeah, that is the limitation, so I can't. But I am the management professor, so I don't want to waste my time because madam given time. So few minutes I want to utilize that. So I am Professor Sri Ramulu. Ramulu. Normally North India, Ram, Sri Ram. Here, Ramulu, they will be say that. ULU, three words there. But pronunciation part, if you go North India, they will call sometime and hear us like. Okay, so I'm hailing from the Warangal, which is 150 kilometers away from the Hyderabad, Kakatiya's capital. And my, because there we have that MBA set, 1 lakh students written in that. Fortunately, I got admission in the Usman University campus. Now also we have that two Indian sections, two foreigner sections, two foreign sections, especially for the foreign students. And besides that, we have that MPhil, PhD and this program. And two most important like that, each and every IPS also will become our student because we design their curriculum for all the police officers. And we will conduct the examination, Viva Voce, Project Report Evaluation like that. And another for the defense personalities. While we are coming, I explained to the madam like, Master of Management Services for the military senior people. Next we have the MPhils, next that the PhD for the colonels, major and bonnet. So that is. And my personal credential, I have that 70 articles. But if you visit the website, that 52 articles I kept because last year data. And 15 articles are peer reviewed. And 10 books edited, but that is limited to my geography, my area, that is the management. And earlier, I already visited as a AACT member, AACT scrutiny committee, as well as that inspection committee to various states. And right now I'm a Dean CDC, so I'm involved in the UGC related activity, especially autonomous college issues. And beside that, recently, I mean last semester we changed the BBA syllabus for Tota Telangana and now we are doing for the MBA for like that. So that is all my job related. And today I am very happy because madam already told this city is not a new to me because I visited 5 to 6 times this city. Various because in Cochin University sometime I will come to conduct the PhD by Vivas. like and other confidential or sometime that vacational purpose when you come to one other term. And here friends, like that my responsibility, most important point that today I am so happy because today I am discussing with all the experts who have their skill base and their knowledge in their respective areas, because in this domain everybody is an expert and each expert versatile in their own area, right? So my duty is that actually 4th to 7th we are going to the IGNOU New Delhi, your main. So in this they told me that you visit the center, then I said that okay, because normally that the superior committee NAC, they say that you have to go and visit, then I said okay. And my job is that just the chairman called me and said that you observe everything and prepare a small note about that and you submit to the us, so that is. And he more focused about the, to be frank, the technological issues, what kind of technology, because you are the role model and you are reaching the vast students, because regular universities they are limited, but you, there is no limit for knowledge like a sky. You can reach any corner of the country because no geographical territory for you. Like our small city, only Telangana, we can't go beyond Telangana like that. So that's why the technological issues as well as that other. And today most important thing that my observation, and beside that if you say something I will note down and I will learn something being a teacher, because I want to explore, I want to learn, that is the most important things. And what my superior given like that, I will give that a brief report about that. So thank you madam, and thank you all. And once again wish you happy and prosperous new year, because yesterday only we celebrated new year. And I pray almighty to each and everybody should be happy in this year, because last year 2020 lot of problem everybody faced. So this year we should not be like that. So thank you, and thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Thank you sir for your kind and encouraging words. Your encouraging words are a motivation for us, and we look forward to more interactions with you during the day sir. Now I request all my colleagues to just briefly introduce themselves, those who are sitting in the audience please.
Joseph sir, start, please start.
I'm Joseph, but not Mr. Joseph. No, from IBM.
Sir, you are specialized in?
Of course.
I am a non-academic job.
Okay.
Right.
I'm Dr.
Devade
Kumari. Assistant Regional Director. My discipline is education. I was working as a like assistant professor, associate professor in a training college, teacher education college. And I have experience in school teacher, as a school teacher also. Here I am working as assistant regional director for 10 years.
Good. Thank you. Your name?
Sir, good morning. I am Jyoti S. Patadeh. I am deputy registrar. I am heading the regional evaluation center here. It is one of the 7 regional evaluation centers in India.
Sir, one not too small question.
Yes.
How many evaluations do you have for the PG?
PG program?
PG and professionals.
Sir, that details I will give you, sir.
Normally?
Sir, we have not gone into the details of program wise. In total, last examination, the last examination we had 67,000 answer books being processed. Okay. I can give you the...
Here my question, that do you have that single evaluation, double evaluation of if the 20% will be different than third evaluation like that?
No sir, as of now there is only single evaluation. And we are getting the answer books evaluated by approved teachers from all over India.
Approved teacher by the concerned
board? School board, school board, approved.
Okay. Concerned
school. Sir, I am Mohammed, sir. I am working here as Assistant Executive Data Processing. I am working for the last 6 years.
Earlier you were with Pune. You can tell that way also, please.
Seriously posted in Pune.
Okay.
They go transport.
Okay.
Sebastian DeCruz. From 1991 onwards, I am here.
my presentation on executive data processing.
Nitranjan K. I am the coordinator of LSE 14184 and I'm retired professor. I'm associated with the group for past 25 years.
Your specialized area, sir?
Literature.
I'm Dr. Prema, coordinator of LSE 14180, which is the Model Studies Center and the students on the same campus. And before coming to, I was with HOD and the professor in zoology in one of the colleges.
Working as an assistant coordinator in Model Studies Center. Basically, I'm a training college teacher.
I'm proud to Usha Kiran, working as assistant coordinator at 14180. And before coming here, I was there for direct education.
No, you don't take for
my discipline.
This is power.
Power.
Sir, my discipline is botany.
Okay.
My name is V.R. Chandrika. I'm working as assistant coordinator in the Model Studies Center 14180. Previously, I was working as a guest lecturer at Chen College. Thank you, sir.
I'm Anthony P.T. from Devara College, assistant coordinator. I'm working as assistant coordinator at Devara.
I am Dr. Tom Varghese from SH College, Devara. I am the coordinator of the study center 14.
You have specialized areas?
My area is literature, especially Hindi literature.
That center only, the other city.
Yeah.
Sample
store. Okay.
So
then you are taking a better
center.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Myself, Dr. Rajni Bhatt, sir. I'm the coordinator at Cochin College. I'm working as an assistant professor at Commerce Department in the college itself, sir. The college has been the IGNO study center has been acting as exam center also for past few years.
So only commerce, or do you have management also there?
IGNO Study Centre has activated MBA programs, sir, management programs. But the college has got commerce department today. Recently this year we got sanction for a new PG course from MG University that has integrated commerce and management.
Hi, I'm Kumar, working after coaching assistant.
Dr. Chandrasekharan, working as private secretary and I am in IGNO for the past 28 years.
I am only the section officer. Since 1990 I am working here.
So my name is Sujini Babu, working as assistant.
Stop,
you need to introduce yourself.
I am Rahul. I am working with the infection.
Taumi Krishna, working with IGNO since 2011. I work with Distance Education Council at the IGNO headquarters, Delhi. And later it was shifted to DEC, UGC. I worked on Dean Deputation with UGC for 2 years. And after that, since 2016, I am working at IGNO Regional Center Cochin, sir. So presently I am working here, sir. So thank you. Now I request our regional director, Dr. J.S. Dorothy Madam, to kindly make a presentation about the activities of the regional center.
When I am sharing about regional center Cochin, it will cover certain details related to the regional evaluation center and also the model study center with the code 14K. Because all the three offices exist in the regional center Cochin campus, which spread across 1 acre. So this is the new building which has the picture in it, and this regional center was established in the year 1988, and it covers 6 districts in the state of Kerala and the union territory of Lakshadweep. And as it is evident, the infrastructure of regional center Cochin was made possible with the founding one of the founder regional director who is no more, Dr. Vasudevan sir, and some of the people who worked with him are still there, Dr. Joseph, Dr. Murli, and recently A.R. Murli were also played an important role in acquiring this campus and also the structure to be put up after possession. And so we have two sets of blocks. One is the four-story wall block and the new block is six-story block. And the wall block mainly houses the regional center Cochin, and the new block houses the regional evaluation center and the model study center. And the regional evaluation center, this caters to the seven regional centers in the state of in India. And For Cochin Regional Center, the answer scripts are not evaluated by Regional Evaluation Cochin. So that is how we maintain the integrity and to say that there is no nepotism when we are handling the answer scripts. And the related to the current staff position, we have 16 at Regional Center Cochin. We have 5 at Regional Evaluation Center. And at regional model regional study center, that is, we are having 17 part-time staff. And for the host institution role, we play during the time of the examination and also certain activities for monitoring the counseling session. So budget provision is for the model study center is separate, and it is just treated on par with other learner support centers, and they have to report to the regional center even though they exist in the same campus. And this is what sir was highlighting, so I will touch upon more on this because sir was asking these details. The state and union territory covered for regional evaluation center, we have given data for three sessions. We have two cycles of examination, the June and the December. And this time, the June 2020, due to COVID-19 pandemic, we were able to hold it in the month of September, October. So the still certain evaluation process is on the move. So seven we have covered in June 2019, December 8, and June is again 8. And the regional center cover is 13, 15, and 12. And the examination centers covered in these 13 regional centers, the 15 and the 12 are 138, 129, and 105. And the number of answer script processed are 1972 44 and 166 542 and 67 184. Why it is so low, you may ask? It is because we have covered only the final year. In a UG program, we have 3 years, so first year, second year. And almost the first year and second year are 1.5 times more than the third year students, final year students. Similarly, the first year PG students. So approximately, if you put into 3 for this value, it crosses the existing previous values. And the result declared in 45 days, we covered 87.2% and 92.3%. And this time 87.9%. Because even the Kallur post office, which gives delivery of answer script to the regional evaluation center, was closed for over a month due to COVID-19 pandemic situation. And in addition, the entire stretch of this Kadandra road was also closed due to pandemic situation. And two of the officials of REC was also infected. So we need to close down that regional evaluation center for as per the protocol for quarantine. So those were the reasons for the delay in evaluation of the answer script. And photocopy of answer script application, this reflects that people are not happy with the first evaluation. So it is comparatively insignificant when compared to the total number of scripts processed. And then re-evaluation application, that is also comparatively less. And then evaluators used is 681 for the June 2019 session, 714 for December 2019 session, and 493 for June 2020 session. And among this, the evaluators from the IGNU faculty are 40, 38, 39, meaning we are giving equal importance for the outside education institution faculty. Subject to their empanelment using the evaluator profile available in the regional center and the headquarters website. And the number of courses covered are 537, 463 and 772. And this 772 as third year goes, the number of electives increases, the application oriented courses variety also is more, and thereby even though the answer scripts evaluated are less, the number of courses are more covered in the June 2020 session. And the Modern Study Center, it was established in the year 2016 with the leadership of Dr. M. Rajesh, currently Regional Director R. D. Valathara. And then that was the main need for us to take care of the local needs of the program. And currently we have around 2137 learners for the July 2020 session. And the most prominent is the MA Psychology program, the abbreviated as MAPC. And the Gyanavani radio station is functional through the AIR relay. And we have appointment for the Gyanavani studio at RC Kochi is awaited. And we have the full-fledged studio in campus in the second floor. And the recreation club was also part of the sports and cultural activities, and it was installed in the period of Dr. Professor V.V. Reddy, and it has been a keen role to for kids' attraction, I should say. When there is a family get together, they come to see the gym and go. That is, it is one of the unique feature in a regional center. And the melt van, it was donated by IIT Roorkee. And we use it for UBA activities and initiatives related to it. And the computer lab, sir was asking about the role of the computer lab during this pandemic situation was very high, I should say. They coordinated team through TeamView or the Facebook relay, and we were able to catch it up even in up to 150 kilometers radius without signal distortion. Yes, there was breakage of voice, but still people could get it what we are saying. And then the computer professionals, only we have two, and they were responsible. Of course, the PS and certain academics are also well versed in computer knowledge, and all the officials in Regional Center Cochin are computer literate, so they can handle the computer data independently at Regional Center Cochin. And they were also responsible for molding the Google Meet and also Zoom meeting. And the host institution also helped the regional center to coordinate for certain of the virtual meetings. And one of the meetings where we held the collaboration of the host institution is mainly the induction meeting. So, for example, in SH College, the Computer Science Department, they facilitated the WebEx meeting for induction meeting, and it helped us to accommodate more than the 100 prescribed for the Google Meet. And in addition, we have under the ARIA, the ATEL ranking for institution, we have the Innovation Club mandatory for all higher education institution. The Innovation Club activity and the grievance redressal were in virtual mode during the pandemic situation, and it is likely to continue for another 1 year as per the policy of the university. So the role of the computer, the technology in reaching out this innovation and grievance redressal is also a prominent role which has to be highlighted now to the floor. And I also have to record one more thing. See, every time when grievance redressal camp is held, generally people go with a heavy heart, and also the employees, that's the anxiety of what the student is going to give. Because every time we improve a standard, there is always some other expected standard from the student. So as a novel idea, what we did at Regional Center Cochin, we coupled it with enrichment session of Innovation Club. So we invite either one of the academics or one of our coordinators, they come, or one of our neighbors. For example, the HDFC Bank Vice President, he's just second neighbor for our campus. He was also very open to say about the how a bank interview has to be faced. So that was one topic. And the employment exchange officer came and told what are the prerequisites and how to handle the employment prospects in the state of Kerala, where dislocation is very high among the youth. So all these aspects, when a guest is there, generally the student undress is minimized. It's not suppressed. It is minimized, and the presence of a guest help them to get accustomed to new venue, and they have some message to take home besides the grievance redressal. All this are possible mainly due to technology during this pandemic situation. And we have a library collection, and we have a help desk reception, and even help at the online activity help desk reception is mainly facilitated by the computer and online link in the Samarth portal. And we have enough facilities for the differently able, and this ramp is also our Facebook icon. And you may ask why we have taken this ramp as a Facebook. We look, this is not as a ramp. This is also a roadway to success for anyone who come to IGNO. It is also a path for continuing education for any aspirant of higher education. It is maybe also a ladder of success for somebody who is just coupling some other program, even though they have already reached the highest in their education scenario. So that is what we look forward when we come for inclusive education. And we always integrate the differently able with the mainstream. That is what our government also insists upon, and the UNESCO and the Salamaca agreement also emphasize on. So we do not segregate at the reception. That differently able has to say, if they want to come to the mainstream of education, yes, they are integrated in the examination hall in the counseling session. Unless otherwise, they express themselves that they want to have a separate room to write the examination, which is also permissible. And we, due to certain calamities in life, which is uncertainties due to accident, etc., if a normal, who has not been indicated as differently abled in the application form, encounters some difficulty in doing, with the proof of medical certificate, we facilitate scribe also for writing the examination. And during the pandemic situation, it is highlighted that we have, as per the nodal officer Kerala government initiative, we were supposed to accommodate even the quarantine learners, and we have done. And the role of examination center at that time was very crucial. And we also have to say that we did not use it for 1 week, that room. So that much infrastructure facilities we have to accommodate anyone, whether it is special need or whatever demand they wanted. And this is the just geographical map which we need to share. The location, actually the Kerala state, the middle part is related to our Cochin Regional Center, and the island in the Arabian Sea, the Union Territory of Lakshadweep. And the six districts are Ernakulam, Thiruchur, Palakkad, Kottayam, Idukki, Alappuzha, and the Union Territory of Lakshadweep. So totally seven jurisdictions we have. And this is the admission status. And I will explain it better with the use of this graph. I will say there is a steady enrollment increase from 2014, and the current is 28,517. And when we talk about the enrollment, we always say the fresh plus the RR. What is fresh is the first time takers, first time access to the higher education. The RR is the second time takers, meaning the second year students or the third year students. So, and there can be a gap between the first year and the second year registration depending upon the student's phase of study and also the maximum period which the program has. So, we have to wait for the second year students or the third year students to come. But first year is due to promotional meeting and on their own will to join the IGNO program of study. And constantly there has been an increase. When compared to July 2019-2020, we have 13% increase. And this is the divide between urban, rural and tribal. There is a steady increase in the rural area in the year 2020. And the enrollment of students from tribal area is also constant. And the learner profile for women is steadily growing. for the last 3 years. And then sir was interested in statistics, we could not say throughoutly, because in the year 2000 sir, there was a slight dip. So that's why we are highlighting for the last 3 years there is a continuous thing. And promotional activities are there for the specifically for women learners, and we look forward to have more. We have captive audience with the prison inmates, especially in the central Viyur jail. And the uniqueness is that they conducted two excursions. One is education excursion, another one is spiritual excursion. Spiritual excursion, they were given some 200 rupees and they were taken to all the temples and the pilgrimage places. And it was surprising, it seems, that everyone returned back the 200. They never spent anything on it. And then second, so that venture made the police department to have this education excursion, meaning from instead of we holding the counseling session in the prison, they requested the local LSE, that is the Kerala Verma College in Thirchur, and the coordinator and the former coordinator Dr. Ravi was very played an important role in facilitating this. The prison inmates will come in civilian dress, integrated. The prison inmates will be knowing that they are going to be with the civilians, but the civilians won't be knowing of who they are, because in distance education, any learner is away from the institution, away from the peer, and also away from the academic counselor who teaches. So neither of them know who is the learner. So that uniqueness was utilized by the prison inmates to integrate with the mainstream, and it was reported that no one tried to escape during this venture. And their interaction with the academic counselor was also to the point, and they performed better in the examination. And the differently abled admission status is as given in this graph. And the IGNU programs on offer, we have learner support centers at 33 places, of which we have three autonomous colleges. One is Devra College, another one for CMS College, Kottayam, and Teresa College, of which two are in Cochin city itself. And we have program activate adult 89, and the prominent programs are 20 as indicated here, but the highest enrollment is for the BA program. And when you see the level of program, its master's is 25, bachelor's is 15, the postgraduate diploma is 20, diploma is 7, certificate is 20, and the postgraduate certificate is 2. The total LSE and the regional center is 33, of which the regular study center, program study center, special study center, discrimination is 19, 7 and 7 each. Then 18 LSE were established from 2014, and 7 special LSE were established from 2014, and approved academic counselors at IGNO regional center Cochin is 1320, and the district wide split across the jurisdiction of Kerala is also given. Kerala meaning the Cochin regional center is also given. Ernakulam is 627, Tiruchur is 148, Palakkad is 42, Idukki is 196, Kottayam 235, Alappuzha 63, Union Territory of Lakshadweep is 9. The pre-admission counseling and admission is also a part of the regional center, and we generally do relate to the admission process through the Samarth portal. The advantage of Samarth portal is that we need not worry about the the payment premium to be paid. So far we were so the Samarth portal is a new venture in this last year, and it was useful to us when it comes to reaching out to the learners through the help desk. And we have the induction meeting held, and for the first time we were able to produce a YouTube video for induction meeting, and we have uploaded in our regional center website also. As way forward, we are trying to put it under the Creative Commons license and then put it next time onwards. This time we have put it YouTube because The last date was also approaching, and we thought that we should reach out to the learners. An induction meeting, how we held, is the first time of an individual learner to visit the study center. Actually, with the virtual admission process, it becomes very crucial for a learner to know what next after enrollment. So, induction meeting plays an important role. And we always say in the induction meeting, it is learner responsibility, like the small monkey clinging to the mother monkey. They should always catch the coordinator or the email ID which are the help desk. It can be any animate or inanimate object, which will be the mother monkey role in the, during the study period. And we also say it is like getting into the train into a specific platform. Many a time, the concept of learner support centers, the program specific or program study center differ, so we educate on them. We also tell them about the life skill, especially for women learners, the facilities available. If they are in the pregnancy or in the lactation period, what they have to do and what are the other amenities they have to be careful. Right from the women education of personal hygiene matters, related to use of diaper if they want to sit long or if they want to have a specific arrangement for writing the examination, or to take care of their needs during the period related to the disease management also. We talk it openly, and we have said it in the YouTube also. And during the post-COVID period, what we still insist to continue on the virtual board. So the role of technology in reaching to the learners in the induction meeting is also prominent. An induction meeting held at Regional Center in 2018-14, January and 2019-22, and 2023, and then we went to virtual board. The one highlight is the number of meetings held is reduced due to virtual reach. So, one time virtual meeting, it covers more learners, more places than what we expected through the face-to-face board. So, academic counseling, pre-COVID situation, pre-pandemic situation was through the face-to-face mode. During the pandemic, we got accustomed to online counseling. At this time also, the role of technology was very high in reaching out to the learners. And the regional center coaching was the first regional center to prepare the Google Help Meet to reach out to the study center. We also prepared the health guidelines. And one of our AEDP, Dr. Ansar, he was responsible for preparation of that. And we have uploaded in the website also. And it was used as a base initially. Of course, initially the seating capacity was more than it was reduced. And we were accustoming to that, and we got accustomed to other modes of technology reach like Facebook, and also the Twitter and the SMS was also on high use during the pandemic period. And in the post-pandemic period also, we are likely to continue the same trend as it reaches to more people at less, and the cost effectiveness is also more. Till date, we have conducted 334 online counseling. All this are possible due to the use of technology at Regional Center Kochi. The cumulative academic counseling face-to-face is 11,841. In 2020, it is 334 online counseling. You may ask why the data is small. It's not small. The virtual means of communication means more reach, more LSE can be clubbed, cost effectiveness, and more peer interaction across the LSEs, irrespective of the program where they have enrolled or the LSE to which they are attached. The monitoring of support services, we were able to doing face-to-face interaction, checking the records, and with the video and the audio use of technology, many a time the present is absent statement was shown in the video for us to assess. So virtual meet, and they also sent it as an email attachment. So we were able to coordinate. And sample examinees were also interacted whether the facilities are there. And this June 2020 examination was fully on virtual monitoring, supplemented with face-to-face. So the monitoring of learner support centers in 2017 was 9, 18 was 14, 19 was 14, and 20 was 6 virtual meeting for sustenance of support services, and 514 virtual examination center interaction. that this is the one of the highest, this is also possible, highest interaction with the LSE was made possible due to the use of technology during the COVID pandemic situation. And we are likely to continue the same use of technology for the coming examination also scheduled to be held in February. Facilitating dispatch of study material, certain materials are dispatched from headquarters. And we have very good liaison with the Kallur Post Office, and I acknowledge with thanks the role played by the Postmaster General also in during the pandemic situation to store the unserved material. And the unserved materials are generally collected, and Dr. Joseph is helping us in this regard. And former the assistant registrar also played a significant role during the pandemic situation. And the learners are sent SMS, again use of technology. We have a personal touch, again we use the phone to interact with them. And again we remind them during the induction or the counseling session, because during this virtual counseling session or observations or the sustenance meeting, one of the academic is also part as an observer. So they will be telling some highlights of what they have to do. And the learner can send the representative also to collect the study material. And we have all the study materials uploaded in the eGyanakosh, the digital library of Indira Gandhi National Open University, which is for public access also. And in the help desk, we also help them to download those study materials for use by the learners. The assignments online submission. We are highlighting about the use of technology. So technology played an important role in submission of the assignment response during this pandemic situation, and is likely to continue for another one more year at least. And where the students have the liberty of not visiting the study center, not incurring any expenditure beyond what they have to write in a paper, there's no expenditure of traveling or postage. So what we, and as a guideline, we all always tell, we hold a meeting in this induction meeting also, plus in between one meeting for the deadline to be met for assignment response submission. And Dr. S. Vijay Raghavan is coordinating for this activity. And wherein we say that the procedure to scan, many a time they we insist that it should be scanned by keeping the paper below the hip level if they are standing, or keeping in a chair and they have to stand and scan. And we also say that the assignment response should be numbered correctly, the page numbers should be there, and the postcode should be written. And some possible mistakes like attaching the same assignment response for multiple courses, that also we say as a preventive measure. So all this reach to the home or the work spot of the learners. And if you see the virtual meeting, some are traveling, even in the bike they were listening, and 2-3 learners were in the bus, they were listening. So it have triple promotion meeting, I should say. See, somebody is talking over a phone in a bus, definitely others will be listening also. So we through virtual meeting we got invisible aspirants for higher education of IGNU. But these people will come into the mainstream maybe after the release of the advertisement or of the press release. So the coming session will tell how effectively we have reached to the virtual mode. And this is the term and examination. The exam is for June 2020 at IGNU. Face to face, they are supposed to come face to face. That's examination. 32,762. And BCA NCA online practical examination was attended by 866 examinees. BSc Lab 30, BLIS 55, MAPC online is 125. Project Viva conducted online for 8 programs is 195. And the programs for which Viva was conducted was MAPC, Project Internship, PGDFSQM, BCA Project, MCA Project, MA Education Project, PG Diploma in Education Technology Project, and MSc CFT Program, Family Therapy Program. In this, I also want to highlight that the use of technology in facilitating the internal component, where a face-to-face interaction has already taken over, was possible due to use of technology. For example, MAPC project People have to do some study, whether it is secondary, based on secondary data or primary data. Still, when they were presenting their project, they posted it. And then we sent it for evaluation, and there was also option for them to upload it in the online link. And we downloaded it and we gave it to the evaluator, and Viva OSA was conducted to the virtual mode. Dr. Jalja Kumari, ARD, facilitated this online conduct of virtual Viva OSA. So what I am trying to say is, during this pandemic situation, technology played us to fulfill the prerequisites of a from learner side, and to certify the prerequisites already submitted from the distance education institution side. So both were possible, leading to the access of the program initially, which happened either more than 2 years, I should say, if it is in the case of 3 year program, 2 years in the case of PG program, so that they are ready for the next convocation to be certified as successfully completed. Connecting with learners at RC through ICT and social media. Once again, I just recap it. The Facebook, we have the icon of a slope. We call it in the general term ramp, but we call it as a slope to success. Okay, why we have put it a slope to success as a icon is that anyone can access to education. And the thirst for education is from cradle to the tomb. That's what our ancestors also say. And the importance of education is also said that we relate to our school more and then to what is being held now. So whatever they have missed out the education, they have to re-get it, or they have to get it before they exit the world. So this is not, it doesn't mean that distance education system is only for people who are distant from the education system. No, it is for people who have missed the opportunity due to the physical or family or due to some job commitments. And so that is why we have the icon of slope of success or pathway for higher education, however you call it, for the Facebook icon. And Twitter also we reach it, and it is more effective than the SMS because the length, number of words covered is easy to be manipulated, and reach to learners is also more. We have an email ID. The regional center email ID is given. We receive it in one channel for single window operation of technology. For any technology, we need to have single window operation. Only then it is success. But we consolidate the activity by diversified sections head. So each section have an individual email ID. We get it forwarded, and the consolidated report is sent by means of the monthly monitoring report to the regional services division. And we have our regional center Cochin website for customizing to Cochin regional center learners, and IGNU website, which is the main university website. The academic counselor at LSE oriented, and the coordinators meeting held was also through the virtual mean. So the role of technology to convey what are the policy decisions during this pandemic situation was very high. And also the sustenance of the support services at the learner support center was also possible due to interaction through the virtual mode using the technology. And student grievance redressal, this I have linked it up with my previous presentation on ARIA related to the innovation club activity for grievance redressal. This is also multi-channel, but use of technology, reception and online desk, again they can call, they can send the email, they can send the details. But for financial literacy related to payment alone, physically the person has to be present for ensuring that the right credit card or the debit card is used. And then email letters is also having personal touch by giving feedback for the comments for solution to the issues raised. The iGram, the student redress it in the technology enabled website portal, which is visible to all our officials, and we have to solve the issue. And the grievance redressal and open session, this is through online, mainly during the pandemic situation, coupling with the innovation club activity. And the alumni association and campus placement cell is also functional at the regional center Cochin. And we were privileged to have the government district employment office, the in charge person, our officer, to come and empower our learners to talk about what are the prerequisites to be to get registered in the employment exchange. And getting employment in Kerala is one of the ways to prevent dislocation of the youth, and thereby having preventing social problems like the parents left alone, the children working somewhere else. And the promotional initiatives we have undertaken are letters, email being sent to institution and colleges, reaching out to women, backward tribal areas, the Kudumbashree, that is self-help group workers, residents welfare association, the tolling officials, the collaboration with IQAC of host institution, the men and women jail inmates, the police official, promotional stalls in public places through AIR and FM radio. And in this, all this, even during this pandemic situation, we were able to hold a promotional meeting due to the virtual meeting hosted by the host institution. And then we were also able to give a spread a message of how we handled the pandemic situation till the conduct of term and examination through headquarters Gyanavani Radio. And we were also responsible to keep the learner accustomed to the massive online open course. The uniqueness of massive line, online open course is that you need not pay the fee at the initial period. So how during the pandemic situation, how effective we can keep the youngsters in the home active was highlighted by telling the means to enroll into the Swayam portal. And we are also proud to say that three of our staff are part of the MOOCs faculty under the leadership of the former regional director Dr. M. Rajesh, currently regional director Vadagara. And the promotion, this is the evidence of the use of technology and during the promotional initiative. And the tribal reach, if you see the second photo, you can see this is in the tribal hamlet with the that was possible due to the efforts of Dr. Jalja Kumari. And the promotional initiative outside campus was mainly face to face. We have conducted in bus stand in Vidyodaya school during our resource meeting there, and also at a model study center. And this is the status of the promotional initiative undertaken from 2017 to 20. We can see that it's constantly on the rise. Till 2019 for face-to-face mode, in 2019, it is because through virtual mode, the number of reach, the quantum of reach is more, so the number of efforts is also come down. And it is a positive indicator of the use of technology for promotional meeting. Press release and advertisement are done in English and Malayalam language. And this is the 33rd convocation photograph. We coupled it for Vadagara Regional Center and Cochin Regional Center. The report presented is available in Regional Center website along with the video recordings and the still photography taken. And this is the data related to the degree awarded. And this is the this will be more indicative on the table based in the previous slide. So there is a steady increase. And administrative activities, the mandatory requirement of internal audit has been fulfilled. The CAG audit has also been fulfilled in the year 2018. The internal audit in the year 2020. And we have empaneled our security agency through the GEM portal. And also the manpower services have been elicited through the GEM portal, and our purchase of through the GEM portal only. And extension of outreach activities, the UPA activities, the one plant, one student tree, the concept that was also launched. And Mulanthuruthi block development officer was kind enough to give free samplings to be used for this one student, one tree campaign of Regional Center Cochin, and we acknowledged it with thanks. And this Unnat Bharat Abhiyan few glimpses we are just giving, it's more mainly related at the village level. The Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, mainly because it's spread across 1 acre campus, each during the Swachh Bharat activities in January 2020, 1 week long session was held and we had this oath taking ceremony, the campus cleaning, poster and slogan competition on the themes of water and forest conservation, training on best on top waste. We have one resource person that was made possible due to the efforts of Dr. Prema for making a demonstration of paper bag at Regional Center Kochi. And IGNO students of BSW volunteered to paint the school, village school walls and make the students aware of the cleanliness drive. And these are some of the activities. The first is the presentation, and the next one is cleaning the campus, the poster prepared by the participants. The gender sensitization, we are inclusive for transgender, and we have put the application form also indicated for to specify the third gender. And we, as regional center activity, we always take over from what has been left by the former regional director, and that's why this is a small link of 2017. Dr. M. Rajesh, the former regional director Kochi, currently regional director Vadodara, where Ms. Tripathi Shetty, a transgender activist, she came and told about gender sensitization in relation to transgender, and it also opened the avenue for sale of their products. And digital initiative as such, mainly it is for the financial literacy, we got it translated in Malayalam. And we are also proud to say that even this in Regional Center Kochi, proficiency in two languages for the MOOCs program has been, translators has been there. One is Malayalam, another is Tamil. And then even the YouTube video, keeping in view the national education policy importance for regional language, we are planning to translate the English induction meeting video into Malayalam and also Tamil. And it will be uploaded in another 1 or 2 weeks. And financial literacy program was also held by the IDBI, HDFC, ICICI Bank, because constant updation of knowledge was necessary to keep abreast with the government policy and Digital India initiative. The celebration of National Festival and IGNO Foundation Day is evident. The photograph on the other side is the recently held Independence Day celebration. And collaboration, this is the first activity without financial liability on IGNO. So, we are proud to say that Vidodia School helped us to have this resource person in their venue, and all the academic staff served as resource person, and the administrative staff in whatever back office operations they can do. So this is the first financial, without financial liability, the first collaboration with an outside agency. And this was the pre-launch meeting and also the day of the Vidya Gala conference. And this with QSAT, we have a very good technology, and the Kochi University of Science and Technology, they have the Department of Neuroscience, where the project Udbodh. It relates to the Alzheimer's disease prevention, and our students were involved in it under the placement drive also. And Eat Right India movement is a part of the Government of India initiative, which says you are what you eat. So the collaboration was possible due to the effort of Dr. A.K. Prema. And we collaborated with the Association of Food Scientists and Technologists of India, Cochin chapter. And we could have a panel discussion on the Eat Right India movement. And we were part of the celebrations, right from inauguration to holding the meeting and also giving away the certificates. The best practices of Regional Center Cochin, I will say, is the diversity which converge in a universe solution. So I will say all the academics are from different spheres of specialization, and all contribute for the welfare of the students when it comes to a solution. And the online counseling session held 3:34, mainly for this Jan 2020 during the pandemic situation, was possible due to the use of technology. And the role of our administrative staff in facilitating the online counseling has to be acknowledged here, because they were the one who were in the back office, so that the academics can be in the front office to handle the show. And we have newsletter, all the documents have been all the information have been documented in a new newsletter, Polymbic. It is named as Polymbic by 4-member team in the year 2017, again under the head of Dr. M. Rajesh. So far 10 issues have come up, and open camp enrichment sessions we have held 17 since 2018, along with innovation club activity under ARIA, the title ranking for institution. And our online help desk is also fully technology enabled. You come with your hard copy, you can go with your enrollment number. That is what we say, and we do follow it also. And research publications of all the 5 academics has been uploaded in the website. And people have participated in the Gyanavani talk session, telling the experience of Regional Center Cochin. And 8 MOOC courses on online has been translated into Malayalam under the leadership of Dr. B. Sugumar, Nodal Officer, and also Regional Director Trivandrum. And 1 course in Tamil language. And 28 workshop, FDP, and webinars have been attended by the resource for the Regional Center Academics. 6 virtual lectures were delivered, with meaning they were served as resource person. And certificate of merit experience during the innovation club of NCID was also possible during this pandemic situation. And out of the 4 challenges held, 2 challenges certificate merit has been obtained by the academic. And innovation and distinctiveness is to highlight the best regional center award obtained twice in the year 2007 and 2011. And credit goes to the former regional director who has set the trend. And we have the MOOC faculty under the MHRD, under the principal coordinator Dr. M. Rajesh. The 3 faculties are Dr. Sindhu P. Nair, Dr. V. T. Jalja Kumari, and Dr. Prasita Unnikrishnan. And the team also won the best online course award for the year 2020, which was given on the foundation day of IGNU. And innovation club activity is also fully online during the pandemic situation. And we have the COVID-19 cell, and which integrates the government policy for implementation at regional center level. What is the way forward as? Is online virtual system to supplement the existing face-to-face activities wherever it is possible. Creation of free online resources. Cost effectiveness, ensuring at all levels for effective resource utilization. Skill-based program. The MOOC on learning Malayalam language. This is our Vice Chancellor's motive also, to keep in view with the national education policy, giving importance to the regional language. And already BFC program has been translated into Malayalam language. The proposal has gone to headquarters. School board has approved. Anytime the implementation will be imposed. And solar power utilization. And this PowerPoint will be available after this presentation in the IGNU website. You can download it for public access. And thank you, and over. And we look forward for any questions from anybody else.
You should ask them any questions.
Any questions?
Now from the students asked. And now we are like your students. Mm-hmm. First, I want to ask a few questions, madam. So already we told that one violation. What is the moderation marks criteria? You have the strategic moderation when you declare the result. Anyway.
Moderation. Sir, I will tell, sir. Actually, we give door-to-door evaluation for the evaluation of answer script, and there are 2 ways to redress the evaluated answer script. One is by obtaining a photocopy of the answer script, and the second one is by asking for re-evaluation. Whenever I also had the personal experience of working on pilot basis when the regional evaluation center was established in Chennai, when I was on the role of Chennai Regional Center. So whenever somebody is asking for photocopy of answer script, we will be alerting ourselves and will keep that answer script separately. And the next if they are redressing through asking for re-evaluation, then again we will send it for the second evaluator. With blindfolding all the earlier documented awards, and the best of the award will be given. That is one moderation, and there is no second re-evaluation. And many a time
here my question is that as per UGC guidelines, normally any university up to 55% they have to pass mark selection. So like first plus 3, plus 2, plus 5, that kind of formula do we have here?
2% moderation is there, sir.
2%. And you are saying, madam, so they can challenge up to the quota, court of law, what? Because
so far,
in few university, what they said, they are giving copies. But after that, where they can go there? So do you have any mechanism?
No, sir, that is what, the more we are controlling our mechanism for quality work, the number of student unrest due to evaluated answer script will be less. That's what, so far we have not, anyone has not taken to court. Any of Dr. Joji can talk on
that. Sir, nobody has taken to court, but there is a provision, they can represent. If there is anything missing, sometimes there may be a dawdling mistake, or sometimes for particular answer, the mark is not given. In such cases, they can represent. And we will check the original answer book. If there is a dawdling mistake, then we will forward it to headquarters for correcting the mark. And if any question is missed out, we will send it back to the evaluator who violated it and ask him to review and send it back.
Experts, are they giving keys?
Yes, if the school is provided, then we will give the keys to the experts.
Question papers have been uploaded in the regional center website also.
So this time also you grant a traditional model.
Yes.
But this time question paper was received online. So use of technology in receipt of question paper was significant. So contactless delivery of question paper.
Madam, how many contact classes we will arrange for one subject?
8.
8 for UG?
Yeah, that is the maximum session which we hold.
8.
And it is based on credit basis.
Is it 1 hour or 2 hours?
2.5 hours.
2 hours. 2.5 hours or 2 hours?
2 hours.
2 hours means 16.
Yes, sir.
This for UG or PG, both?
Both. And the course structure is 2 credit, 4 credit, 6 credit, 8 credit. And certain programs we have consolidated online counseling by headquarters itself. Those counseling sessions are not covered at regional center.
Even study material also provided by the national level or here also?
Study material is sent, whether enrollment is centralized, so they can opt in any of the 67 regional centers. And examination can be under any of the 67 regional centers, subject to activation of that particular examination. Not all study centers are examination centers. And the counseling sessions are now, during the pandemic situation, we have consolidated it across the LSEs, so that there is cost effectiveness and there is enhanced peer interaction when it comes to the learners.
Madam, do we have the plagiarism?
No, so far it has not been encountered, sir.
It has
for
a project PhD.
Yes.
Now we are implementing only 10% of presentation. Up to last year, total throughout country 25, but now that reduced to 10% plagiarism. Any other thing?
Anything something more after magic presentation.
I am Dr. Paul Murgis from Second Heart College, Tevara. I am the coordinator there. And actually, we have nearly, per year, we have nearly 1,400 students. And regarding the MP students, we have some 250 MP students we have. And we are really impressed by the enthusiasm they show us. And one thing I have noticed that some students told me they had sent their answer book for revaluation, but when revaluation is there, they are not satisfied with the revaluation. We do not know what is wrong with that. Perhaps the students may not have written properly. That may be the reason, but they told us, and I told them, if you are the, usually we, after evaluation, we take the better marks, I think, when 2 marks are there. So, that thing, we cannot say anything about it. And this time, actually, they had so many disappointments because that is not our fault. Actually, we have the COVID situation is there, and the face-to-face classes they enjoy, because really in our counseling classes, the students get much time for clearing their doubts. Usually when they are coming for the classes, they will be bringing with them so many doubts to be cleared, and they will be in need of some actually highlighting the portions, and such opportunities are not available now. Actually, the online classes, we cannot have much interaction with the speaker, the academic counselor. So that is, we cannot find fault with that. That is it, they have saw the situation. But actually, students are very eager to have, to get the original situation. They really enjoy that, and we find that the students are...
That is the global level, not in our country context,
yes,
or
yes.
One state, that is the global level.
Yes.
But any best practices in your center?
Pardon?
Any best practices?
Best practices. Yes. In our center, actually, students, they form some WhatsApp groups, and they have some very good interactions. They form when they join the classes. When they come together, they form very good WhatsApp groups, and they will be the students will be.
The online classes.
Yes.
What platform you are using?
Google Meet.
And WebEx.
Yes. And recently we had conducted induction meetings, and that was very encouraging. Students were very much impressed, and we got the response that it was very useful. And actually, so we are thinking of conducting more such classes to the students. And they usually, actually these students, they when they come together, they prefer the combined study, and the interaction with their seniors is also very encouraging. They help each other, and we find that so many students have this passed the NET examination, or ICNO students, and they are getting appointment in the colleges also. And previously there was the impression that this distance education is not so good as the our regular education, but that idea is now totally changed. They find the importance and the use of the distance education, and they are actually thrilled knowing that they are a part of the Central University, which is the largest open university in the world. When they come to know about it, they are very happy, and they are thinking of getting more conveniences and facilities. And we have to make with our limited facilities, we want to make more, give them more facilities regarding the reading room and the library, etc. It is not mainly now we are using
the digital library.
They are getting
desk of e-gyan courses, can highlight upon
yes,
digital library.
E-gyan courses digital library
is available
in the website. And if possible, you can show that can be important, because now today they asked me to verify that technological basis.
Yes, sir. We will take the feedback, sir.
Your permission? Yes,
sir. Any technological related, sir? Sir, any technological upgradation?
Yes.
Technological upgradation.
Upgradation, actually, we are using the ICT, and we have examination halls with this CCTV and other things. We have got these machines, and we are using with the help of the these equipments. The class are so many classes are well equipped with these systems. So the students really very much enjoy that, and they are. They have more interaction with us when they come to know about the and the usual
so
visits.
So one word you said that earlier distance, there is no distance now between teacher and student.
Yes, yes.
Because of the technology. So thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
And here my thing is that I want to cover many things, and I want to give the brief report to them. So in technological related,
we will prepare it, sir. Yes.
Yeah.
And this is the E-Gyan Ghosh website, how it looks like.
Oh, E-Content
App. E-Content App. We can download it for you, sir. We'll give you PowerPoint on all this, whatever add our information.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. It is a NAC accredited institution.
Yes.
And as per ICRO norms, we can activate PCI MCA program only if the original software is there. And it is one of the PCI MCA activated LSE.
Because of the time limit, we could not hear
some
90.
Thank you.
And recently, President of India visited the
study.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you so much, sir.
Now
I request
you
come now.
Yeah, anybody,
Dr.
but
bring him.
Bring him. Bring him. Bring him. Bring him.
Bring
him.
Bring
him.
Bring
him. Bring him.
Bring
him. Bring
him. Bring him.
Bring
him.
Hello.
Yes. My friend, first of all, let me thank all the officers, regional director, and all the other ARDs and other officials for giving me a chance to present the report of the activities of the SC14000. Then I have prepared only a few slides, of 10 slides, and it will take only 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Because everything is there, and the detailed report will be given to you later, okay. Because it is already typed. So only the gist I am giving. Okay, some of these slides are actually repetition of what Dorothy ma'am told. So I am not coming to repeat all these things. So this study center was activated in 2016, as she told, when the study center, St. Albert's College, 1412 was closed. All the students were shifted to this center. And so including BSc, so at that year we had a high enrollment, and after that there was a decrease for R, there was no RR for BSc. And after that there's a steady increase in the enrollment. Okay, now these are the programs activated. Next slide, please. This is actually the admission data. There will be some difference because we have taken the individual program and add together. So there's some people might have left the center, and some people might have come from other centers too, because it is a center. This center is a very attractive because it's in the heart of the city. So there may be some difference, and the FR actually she explained fresh registration and RR. Only with respect to 2016, there is a difference because this high enrollment for FR, that is actually the BSc students who are shifted from St. Albert's College. That's why the RR is very low actually. Okay, next one. Now this is the study center functionaries, actually the staff, people, part-time, all the study center staff are part-time staff, including myself. This is actually the structure. We are a coordinator, the assistant coordinator. There are three assistant coordinators, and each one is given three assistants for assisting. The work is divided among the different assistant coordinators, and each assistant coordinator will be assisted by three assistants and also the attendants. And finally, we have a sweeper, and she is actually the sweeper from regional center, because all the support and cooperation are given by regional center. Next slide. So these are the, there is no need of reading all these things, the names and all. Okay, these are the names of the staff. There are 17 staff, including the coordinator altogether. Now, because the work is going very, very smoothly, because all these staff are very, very cooperative. And very understanding, very cooperative. So there is no problem for me. Just smoothly running the study center, smoothly running. Okay, now actually the assignments are as three, four stages. First we have to collect submission either offline or online collection, submission, then handling. Now handling means actually sorting this one and entry into the awards and all these are coming under handling. Now after that they will be given for evaluation to approved evaluators.
Here assignment means, do you give the questions only? Then they will prepare and they will give you?
No, the questions will be
centralized
on the website.
Assignment question is centralized, prepared by the program coordinator for each program, uploaded in the website. Again, role of technology
but
for multiple
classes. Student-wise different or same question?
Same question. We will be careful to see there is no copying, there is no plagiarism and all. The evaluator, they are very conscious, very efficient evaluators who are retired after 20-25 years of experience.
But they will write their assignment at their home, no?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
It's like equivalent to open book test.
Yeah.
But there is no
sample copying. How many marks
do you have
for the assignment?
30%.
70 external, 30.
Yeah.
And it's a prerequisite for appearing in the term and examination. And the role of technology in award entry is also to be highlighted through the ARMS.
Assignment we got online. This time, up to the last year, it was only offline, either physical visit by post they sent or by handing over in the study center itself. And this time we had online submission, and they were sorted and given for evaluation, and evaluators sent them office back only through email. And then we take the printout after that. Okay, now the evaluation, after that the awards will be entered. That is also, there is a technology is used. there is a portal given to the study center, and the assistants can entry the awards to the portal. That is what we are doing. Now this actually the number of assignments, the last will be we having completed actually. It is still going on because then yesterday 31st was the last day for assignment submission. So there is a, you know, we couldn't evaluate all these things, and we are in the process of giving the assignments to the evaluators. Now academic counseling, that is the main activity of this study center, everywhere main activity, and you can, this is how we prepare the, this is a system actually. First we prepare the counseling schedule, and that will be submitted to regional center, and the regional center regional director or the person who is in charge of academic counseling will approve that counseling schedule. And approved counseling schedule, after getting the approval, we give the academic counseling. Now, academic counseling actually, we are doing the theory counseling either offline or online. So, offline, as Madam told, the students have to, Tom Marcus are already discussed about the offline and online mode and how the HDT is, I mean, technology is used and all. Now online counseling actually, that was we started online counseling in June. The first 55 classes were given by the study center itself for the study center students. But after that there was a centralization, and the RC was hosting the online counseling. So there's a clubbing of the students from different centers, and most of the actually till today both is organized by RSC and RC together. That is about 250 classes we have already given, and students are very much satisfied with this online classes. And most of them, we got MAPC actually more than 100 people are attending all the classes. I have already given all the data with the files. Now the practicals actually, the online practical has been suggested by the school, and we have practicals for three, that is MAPC, PAPC and CPABA, that is a Bharatanatyam certificate program in Bharatanatyam. So till last year we have given all offline practical sessions. But this time we have given some online practical sessions also. Then as we get the feedback from the learners with about the practicals, and we give the orientation before they go to practical examination, we give a detailed orientation through Google Meet. Now the database of the academic counselors, of course, about 96 approved academic counselors are there. So these are the three practicals I have already told, practicals conducted, BAPC. Actually the students are not there for BAPC, but they are from other centers, various centers, and they are coming here only for the practicals. But theory classes will be conducted in their own center. But MAPC students actually, they are the students of the same one quarter principle. Then ODN, the CPABN, I told you this is certificate program in Bharatanatyam. And this time they have centralized it, and the madam told that it has been, the practicals are directly done by the concerned school. Okay, next please. Now this is the payment norm. There is no much to be explained, that the academic counselor will be given 1100 like that. And 2 hours, theory counseling session is 2 hours, one session, and the practicals 4 hours. Next, the that also madam has already explained, there are two, June and December, there are thermal examinations, and also the TEE, then the TEEP, that is the practicals. Now the meeting, so we I think our study center part-time staff attend all the meetings organized by RC, that is a coordinators meeting and part-time staff meeting, all of them usually attend, whether it is offline or online, and that is why they got a good knowledge of what is happening in the what is their role, what is happening in the RC, what is happening in the study center and all. Then the induction meeting also, we it is hosted by RC, and we also the study center 1400 also actively participated, and I used to give a presentation also during that time. And LSC meeting is nothing but the staff meeting in the department. That is every 3 months we used to meet, and the Bins book is also there. Every 3 months we coordinator, assistant coordinator, and the part-time other staff, assistants, attendants, etc. We meet. Just like the college, we used to conduct staff meeting in the department meeting. Just like that, we also, that is a practice I got from my old college. And because I was actually for 9 years in nursing college, the same practice is done here also, and there will be the evaluation of the work done by the part-time staff. Now these are the workshop. Actually, most of them are hosted by RC, but we also participated in that. That's why I have mentioned this. Bird Food Day, Eat Right. We initiated because my husband is a president of FSGI Cochin chapter, so we initiated that. Then Rajagiri round table, there was a program by Rajagiri School of Management Studies to have monthly awareness programs or panel discussion on various topics related to psychology, environment, education policies, etc. And our students were invited, and we used to participate, especially the second year students. They used to participate, and they give very good suggestions also. Our academic counselor Anand used to participate in that. And that was very much appreciated by this Rajagiri School of Management Studies, because the constant participation. And the news comes in their newsletter also.
Just adding to it, they also have a magazine, monthly magazine called Pandipudam.
Yeah.
In which that round table
is called. Yeah, this round table, in that it is already. Then MOVE program, Madam told that is the program. Actually, how we participated, one of our assistant coordinators was a resource person in preparing the study materials and doing some. And also, we let growth back, sustainable development, and say no to plastic. We have a program, say no to plastic. Under that, we have given some demo of how to make the gold bags instead of the plastic bags. Okay. Then both already told by Dorothy ma'am and Shima, that is a school level programs, and our team, they have already gone about 100 schools in Annapa. I have given the detailed report there. Okay, then Shakti Prerna Puraskar, that is a Puraskar given to a woman who is the best entrepreneur in Kerala. That was conducted here, hosted by regional center. And this is actually, there was an item. This is prepared according to the list given by the lab team. So there was a tutorial presentation. That is why I have given all these activities of this study center. And this is the acknowledgement we greatly. We have the coordinator, assistant coordinators, and all the part-time staff. They are deeply indebted to the regional director, assistant regional directors, and all officials and all other staff members for their support and cooperation, and also the students. Very good students we are having. Thank you once again.
So it's possible through the assignment record submission and management system at headquarters. That is also technology enabled. Now we will be moving to the Gyanavani lab, sir. Just want to share the itinerary. We'll, that is going to be
going to the Gyanavati room from after this session, and then we'll be visiting Model Study Center, then the Regional Evaluation Center, and then we'll be, so please join us for lunch.
We come to an end of this presentation session, and I request Dr. V.T. Jalja Kumari to kindly deliver the vote of thanks on behalf of Regional Center Kochi.
Good afternoon all. I think we are in a hurry to close this session, and you know, without saying how difficult and stressful the situation is, even though sir has come over here to hear us, to see us, to verify everything from our report, and I think we must be that much thankful to him for overcoming all these situations by his commitment towards his profession and his duties. And thank you very much, sir, on behalf of all colleagues and the functionaries of this RC Study Center, and all other other colleagues, friends who are helping us with all support, technically, technologically, and with media support and everything. And in one word, I convey the wholehearted thanks to sir and all other participants on behalf of RC. Thank you very much, and we'll proceed to the next one.
Master of Commerce in Management.
So you have we have eight assignments to submit. So one was
sir, that section one we can. Yeah.
Yeah, I missed the first part.
You can wait there. Yeah. Okay, you can come there after visiting Germany. They will be coming there.
So
the
process is going on.
Yeah, then it is under process. But if you give a you can use this paper,
I'm representing all the batchmates. Okay, not for me. It was it
no,
was
but Jaljaman took it over, isn't it? The project synopsis, which the headquarters gave it little
it
late.
Process and is going on.
The project only?
No, not the project. I'm talking about the assignment.
Study center, they are evaluating. Your study center, they are evaluating. It will come.
That's fine, but we haven't received any acknowledgement.
No, online submission, there is not. Okay, submission through mail only. That. Only offline, only study center will be the receipt.
We get mail?
Yes, yes. No, mail not. When you portal, you submitted mail. Successfully submitted mail, it is the acknowledgement.
I am Dr. J.S. Dorothy, Regional Director, IGNU Regional Center, Kochi. At the outset, I thank my authorities, my seniors, for encouraging me to continue my education and also to upgrade myself, and also to publish papers and also to attend workshops, seminars and conferences right from the inception of my career with IGNU. I joined IGNU Regional Center Jaipur in the year 1997. Then I was on the rolls of IGNU Regional Center Bangalore up to 2006. And from 2006 to 2011, I was in the roles of IGNU Regional Center Chennai. And in 2011, I was made responsible to make the Bijapur Regional Center functional, and I handed over to the regional director. At the time, I was made in charge as deputy director in Bijapur Regional Center. And in the year 2014 to 2018, I was again on the rolls of IGNU Regional Center Chennai. And from 2018 till now, I am working with IGNU Regional Center Cochin. I have completed my BCom, MSc MPhil in Food and Nutrition, MA Public Administration, MA Distance Education, PG Diploma in Higher Education, and I also have continued my education through the Swayam MOOCs program to upgrade myself, and I have attended FDP and Refresher program, and I am also grateful to my seniors and the authorities of the university for encouraging me to publish papers and also to be present papers in conferences, workshops and also in seminars. And I thank everyone who helped me and encouraged me and sustained my interest both in the work and publication at IGNU. Thank you everyone.
I am Dr. V.T. Jalja Kumari, Assistant Regional Director of IGNU Regional Center Kochi. I have started my career as a school teacher for 3 years. Then I have done my career as an assistant professor, then associate professor, and the principal of One Teacher Education College in Idukki district. From 2011 onwards, I am working as Assistant Regional Director of IGNU. And my discipline is, main discipline is education. My PhD is also in education. And I have done my PhD in models of teaching, particularly jurisprudential inquiry model. I am engaged with Learner Support Center establishment, its development, and other related activities in Regional Center Kochi.
I am Dr. S. Vijayaraghavan, Assistant Regional Director working at IGNU RC Kochi. Since 2011 onward, I am working at IGNU. I have posted here in 2017. My area of discipline is pesticide and toxicology. I have done my MSc MPhil marine biology, PhD marine biology and zoology from University of Madras. So here RC Kochi, I am doing assignment and examination related work. And examination point of view, we have activated around 14 examination centers under RC Kochi, which is very much favorable for our student to write the examination at their own locality. We are serving unreached area of this RC Kochi for education and support services. Thank you very much.
I am George S. Patathil, Deputy Registrar and Head of the Regional Evaluation Center, Kochi. I was instrumental in establishing the Regional Evaluation Center at Kochi in April 2017. Before joining REC Kochi, I have worked in IGNU headquarters and Regional Center, Trivandrum. Thank you.
Past 5 years. Previous to working here, I joined IGNU headquartered Delhi at the Distance Education Council in the year 2011. I worked there briefly for a 5-year duration and during which I also worked with University Grants Commission on Dean Deputation for around 2 years. After that, I worked with Campus Placement Cell of IGNU for around 6 months. And after that, I joined IGNU Regional Center Cochin in the year 2016. My discipline is of specialization in social work, and I have authored 2 books and co-authored 1 book and also written various articles in national and international journals. It's a proud moment to also to inform all that we have also won the best MOOC online course of 2020 from IGNU headquarter Delhi on the foundation day. Our course name is Certificate Program in Environmental Sustainability, and this was this course actually was under the leadership of Dr. M. Rajesh, who is the principal investigator, and under him myself, Dr. Prasitha Unnikrishna, Dr. V. T. Jajakumari and Dr. Sindhu P. Nair are all co-faculty who contributed towards this course. So it's a really proud moment to share with you all this. And we also were instrumental in translating 8 SWAYAM courses in Malayalam language as a team at Regional Center Kochi. Myself, Dr. V. T. Jajakumari, Dr. Sindhu P. Nair and Dr. S. Vijayaraghavan have contributed to the translation of 8 MOOC courses of IGNU into regional language Malayalam.
Small is set up for
about 6 to 8 it is a delay, sir. Small is the program which does make it only clear.
Yes, sir.
So there are these two studies of the second module.
Okay, please be seated, sir. This is the office. And all these are the.
She is a resting coordinator. She was a deputy director of education. So these are our part-time assistants.
Student retention, they are the most important.
Yeah.
And enrollment.
And for the online back office work also.
Yeah.
We have created an email ID which is shared by all LLC to consolidate that.
There is a group there for assignment.
Because of this COVID problem.
So this is last session, sir. We have to keep one session's assignments. If there is something. This is last session's man last session. This is the last session and this is the.
It is short mandatory for them to collect and it will be sold and it will be counted under
regional standard. That's a new one. We have to give for evaluations because yesterday, 31st was the last date. And we cannot send the assignments every now and then because of this.
After the evaluation, it will be handed over to students, the pencil students, after evaluation.
Because all our classes are online, we are using the rooms for doing some other same and collection and
Staircase to come out to 4th, 5th and 6th. This is the place we receive the packets from the post office, and as soon as the packet comes, we scan the speed post details and the study center from the examination center from where it comes, and that is recorded into the computer. Now she is scanning the answer books for sending to the students who has asked for a photocopy of the answer book.
Are you charging for that?
100 rupees. Previously it was by offline. So for photocopying and sending we used to charge 100 rupees. Now it is we are sending by email. And in an examination we receive around 4,500 packets from the
examination. Then they can go for open challenging. They assume that they got less marks. So can they go?
They can apply for re-evaluation, sir. And then the answer book will be sent to a separate evaluator. This is the place where we process the answer books. The packet. No, they are taking the reads. Now here evaluation is not happening, sir. Here it is only back of these functions are there. Here the packet receipt will be opened here in this table. And the details will be entered into the computer, there it is. So that the counted number, if it is for answer books are received, it is recorded. And then it will be here, it will be sorted also in the three groups. Now PG group, then BDP, and then certificate and diploma groups. So it will be distributed to three groups. Here three groups will be distributed, and there they will again sort it course wise. Packets will be prepared of 200 to 250 for sending to evaluator. And then here you are giving codes, set code for
student name is there.
No, enrollment number. Everything goes on enrollment number. This is the number. 9-digit enrollment number is there. That is
the first 2 digits indicate the year of enrollment. So 16 means it's 2016
student registration student.
But coding, decoding and all that.
No.
So in our case, what they will do that, I guess.
Yes. The course number.
The course code is written by the learner. This is the program code. I just take this out to explain to you. This answers the friendship. It has the enrollment number. The first 2 digits indicates the enrollment number.
This
is the examination center code. This is the program code, the study center.
Yes. In our course case, code. What we will do? The first page we will remove.
Yes.
First page we will remove.
Yes.
And we will give that another separate number for decoding.
So that is not happening here.
Because here, to be frank, the student number we know.
Yes, sir. No, sir, but here we are hanging it in volume. Mm. 1 lakh, almost 2 lakhs. So the student can have no idea where my answer book has gone. Even for me, to identify where this particular answer book has gone, I have to seek the help of the computer. Then only I can use. Because it may have gone even to Jammu. And we normally try that the senders from Kerala are not sent to the evaluators from Kerala.
Oh. Other states.
Yes, other states.
And multiple locking also, you can tell. That each computer has a security word for the.
Yes, the computer is fully secured and the internal network is not connected to internet. Employees engaged. Those who are working in opening will be shifted here. Those who are working here will be shifted. So they cannot monitor a particular answer book or something like that.
Okay.
Groups. So that there is no privacy.
Right.
Everybody is being watched by others. If somebody is doing something peculiar, that will be reported.
Good elevation, you can see that.
Yes, sir. Can you come to 6th floor? You can make an
interview.
Yes, yes, yes. Nothing is cut, sir. No answer book is cut here.
Only return sheet will be given.
Yes, the sir. The sir will come to me and then it will go to the concerned rooms.
Okay.
And we keep the answer books for 1 year and thereafter it will be sent for
reason. In our case, 6 months.
Yeah.
In this 6 months, student can apply to court after 6 months.
Yes.
Madam, before we are just introduced to the staff,
yes.
Some three staffs are there. Sir, admit to this, our office is from here only. And the staff coming, they will have to keep their baggages outside. They are not permitted to take it. Where are they? Other two. Just call. Call. Kandasamy. Where is Kandasamy? Sir, he is Mr. Venugopal, section officer. He is Kandasamy. Executive data processing. He is controlling the entire database. He is my whatever. He is controlling everything. And he is Balakrishna, civil assistant. Yeah, this is the discussion section. Where we receive the answer books now. They are doing it. Sir, also us. Before going and coming also, this speed post details are scanned and that is entered into the computer. So that movement of the packet from going from here to coming back, everything is recorded. And as soon as we receive the award sheets, we put a tape on immediately before doing the interview, so that it cannot be counted.
Thank you.
And our very senior academic counselor,
and we have our Reverend Father, Vice Principal. Father is also the Academic Counselor of the Nathan here, especially Father is dealing with the, we have BSc classes here, and the Professor and Head of the Department of Botany and the Life Science, and we have Dr. Rijita, he is the Head of the Department of Computer Sciences, and he is our Assistant Coordinator also. We have Shami, our Assistant Coordinator, and all these are our staff members. Sir, Sacred Heart College, Tevara, actually this is a first aid college, and it was established in 1944. And recently we have celebrated the Platinum Jubilee of Sacred Heart College, 1944. Now it's an autonomous college and affiliated to the Mahatma Gandhi University, and the NAC has accredited this college in 2000 with a 5-star, and in the third cycle Dr. Prashant Palikapalli, CMI, and actually he is the principal of the college from 2010 onwards, and he has won 2 awards, being the best principal of Kerala, as well as the best principal in all South India. He has been. More than that, he is an environmentalist and very much interested in organic farming. And this is the founder coordinator of our IGNO here. So it was established in 1996. And the founder coordinator, Father Savians, he was a professor of economics. Now, the present coordinator is myself. I am Dr. Tom Murgis, professor of Hindi. Now, this is our office room, and we will see that office room. Next. And these are our assistant coordinators, Reverend Father Anthony P.T., Reverend Father Nijo Anthony, and Dr. Rijita M.R., and Mr. Shami Joseph. These are our assistant coordinators. These are the administrative staff, Mr. John T.J., Mr. Binoy Anthony, Mr. Babu T.A., Mr. Kuriakos K.J., Mr. Paulos Joseph, Mr. P.P. Varghese, Mr. Netra Bahadur Chhatri, and Mr. Bam Dev Sharma. And this is the IGNO team here, and you can see Father is standing there, our Joseph Father is there, principal, and all the IGNO team is standing there in front of our office. And you should remember the one of the founders of our CMA congregation. This college is founded by the CMA congregation, the first college of the CMA congregation. And we are very happy to say that one of our founders have been raised to the saintdom. That is, now we have Saint Kuriakos Elias Chavara. And if one of the founders are the Catholic Church has made him saint. So we are very happy to have our founder. Now we have BCA, MCA and MBA program. We started in 1996, and we have BSc here, BSc Physics, BSc Chemistry, Mathematics, Botany and Zoology programs. It was started in 2017, and in 2019, MSc Mathematics and PGDOH DVMT started, and MSc ENV Environment started in 2020. And this is the total strength of the students we have. And yes.
EOS 2014, 15.
And we have in 20 January fresh candidates, so 177. And January RR re-registration, 1574. And July fresh. 259,
and in July 2020, 533 and fresh is 792. The grand total is 11,667. That is the grand total the students we had. And we have, before the pandemic period, we had conducted face-to-face induction meeting. And these are the photographs of the induction meeting we have conducted several times. Every semester we used to conduct, having the students from the neighboring colleges, they will be neighboring study centers, they used to come here. Yes, induction meeting. And we know that we take induction meeting very important, because actually induction is it's a part of the human resource development, that is human resource development itself. And sharing knowledge, and after attending the induction meeting, the students are very enlightened and they say that we were very much influenced and improved by the induction meeting. Now this is our computer lab, and we have our main college library. And in this college library, we have made use of the digital board and the NTEL. Actually, our college is a chapter. NPTEL. Our college is a chapter, and the students are making use of it, and they can contact in a national level, and we are very much thinking of the development of the digital world. Actually, when we think about the COVID season, actually we in another way, you have high development in the online classes. Though they were forced to have online classes, it was a kind of blessing for the study, because IGNO is actually always making use of the high tech, and we are very happy that actually the EduSat is meant for this education. We are making use of it, and this is our BSc classes. This is our chemistry lab, and this is the physics lab we are using, and this is the botany lab, and the classrooms we have. This is the botany lab, and zoology lab is here. Our zoology lab is very famous, and we have the classrooms well equipped with the new technologies. These are our halls with CCTV cameras. This is marine hall. This is the life science hall, and these are the equipments and the rooms we have. And actually, after the coming of IGNO, we all, the students and ourselves, feel very proud of our nation, very proud of our country, because when we see that we are part of this open university, which is the largest open university in the world, having some 37 lakhs of students and so many thousands of faculty members we have. So we are very happy about it, and we used to think about the development of India and the future of India, and usually we analyze with the, we make SWOT analysis, and we find actually when we think about the population of India, in another view, we see that actually our population, what is our strength is the large biodiversity and the pool of this human resource. So whenever we think about some demerits, because having population may be sometimes seen as a demerit, but it is a very large human resource, and we have thought about our weakness. And the weakness is actually our self. So self-doubt is our weakness. We are not confident, but we can do so many things. And actually, our APJ Abdul Kalam, he has actually ignited the minds of the young in India, unleashing the power within India. So, when we are thinking about this IGNO and the education, actually the students are thrilled and they are very happy about it, and thank you very much.
So, few questions. Yes, yes. The classes.
Yes.
So, how many classes will you have? Same like 8 classes only?
The norms are the same, sir. The credit was 2, 6, 8 and 10 sessions. It's based on the credits.
For example, regarding the MP classes, management program. So, every day we have actually arranged four classes, 4 periods per day, having 2 hours of duration. 2 hours of duration. We have, that means our classes begin by 9 o'clock and up to 11 o'clock. First period, from 11 to 1 we have the second period, then a half an hour interval, then we will have our next period by 1:30 to 3:30, and from 3:30 to 5:30, such 4 periods are taken by us. And we have our finance papers are taken by our PJ Juni. He is very experienced and he is a chartered accountant. Okay.
Could you explain a few best practices of your institution?
Best practices. What actually?
WhatsApp group.
WhatsApp group. So when the students are, we used to tell the students, when you are joining the course and when you are getting the enrollment number and ID card, and when you are receiving the study materials, actually your classes are started. You have to, when you are getting the study materials, immediately you should be thorough with the practical guide, first of all. Then you should start reading the study materials. And whenever you come across some doubts, you should write it on both sides of the paper. And when you find that some portions are very difficult, then you have to mark their highlight the portion. And actually when you are coming to the classes, we used to say, don't expect the contact classes where the syllabus is completed in the class. We don't have time for that. We have distance education. So, and this is actually their class is, in other words, called group activity. I tell them the professors who are teaching you, they are called academic counselors, and the classes they take is academic and counseling. And the classes you attend, that is a group activity, because each student is coming with his doubts and they will be discussing. Some students will have the same doubts but in the different orientations are there. They will discuss and there will be a group activity. So very energetic, and they make a wall. So WhatsApp group of their class. We have seen that some students, they are making group study. And one day I found that 4 students, they asked me so permission for coming here when the classes are not here. With the permission, they used to come here and they have started studying things. And what was the method they were using? For example, if there are 4 chapters, these 4 students, they will be, each one will be preparing each chapter, and the student will be, one student will be explaining the first chapter and discussing it. And when all the students are discussing 4 chapters, the students who have not seen the second chapter and third chapter and fourth chapter, they will thorough with that. And through their WhatsApp group, whenever a new idea is there, they will exchange it and very happy about it.
And also WebEx facilitated induction meeting.
Yes, yes.
You can talk about that.
Okay.
That is your best practice.
Yes. And the induction meeting, actually, we are trying to use the high tech possible. And in our library is well equipped with such high-tech things, and we have so many highly developed techniques there. The librarian is an expert on that, and we had recently a WebEx we had conducted, and the students who were attending that, after attending this these classes, they were very much pleased, and they said that it was very useful. They were very impressed by, and in these classes, all the regional director and online classes, and the assistant regional directors, and all they always very actively participate in it, and the students are, and they allow the students to interact with the speakers. So they were very much impressed by that.
And also the BSc lab.
Yes, yes.
Because one of the lab centered LSE.
Yes, yes. And especially our life science department is very famous. From the very early time, we had a well developed life science department, and in our botany department, so there are so many unusual the specimens, etc. And we are very happy to say that in the zoology department, we have a channel for actually this our P.A. Sebastian's
arachnology.
Spiders. And actually, once it happened that when in Bengal, they found a particular kind of spider, and they searched about the channels here, and they found that the only channel was that of the SH College, and the BBC actually contacted the SH College, and they asked to all the research college to go to Bengal and find out which is the, what kind of spider is that. So the research college where Dr. P.A. Sebastian was actually in charge of that, and they went there, and it was in great news. So such things are going on there, and one of our fathers, the professor Gabriel, he had actually found out a particular specimen, a new one, and actually it is named after him, Gabriele, and such and very original research work is going on here, especially in life science. Father, you can give
organic farming and bonsai.
Here the students get direct experience. That means each student is taking a job in the lab with individualized equipment and instruments, and they get first hand experience of doing experiments both in plants and animals. And this campus is a biodiversity rich campus. So from my side, when I take a class, I directly take the students to the field and collect the specimen live from there, bring to the lab, and they analyze it. So that experience, I think it is unique for the students. And even after completing the course recently, maybe one or two weeks back, a former student during this Christmas season, she messaged me and wished that I still remember the classes you took. They all were affected by COVID, and but she remembered that maybe 3 or 4 years back she completed the course. So still the students are in touch with me, and they have that experience. They are again trying to have the PG program somewhere, and students are coming from far away places. So even they adjust their time, their family, and they took the train overnight and come out here to have the labs and the classes. So the research experience they directly get at the graduate level. Because we tune the class in such a way that they are prompted to continue the research attitude. So we are.
The same regular professor, sir, we can replace as another counselor for IGMA.
Yes.
The same department college professor, they are taking the classes for IGMA students.
Have you taken any course? Sir, already told in life sciences, have you taken any course?
So, day before yesterday only, the first patent filed from SH College is granted certificate. Because filed in 2009, but it was granted day before yesterday from our water department, actually my guide, Dr. Ramos Francis and Jindu. And it was awarded in 2020 after a long screening process. And there are several students now applying, the patent applications are filed, waiting for the certification. Serious research is going on in all the departments, especially science, zoology, botany, physics, chemistry, environmental science, and recently English departments, and commerce and economics, they are doing the humanities side.
Sir, if you can share some experience in your financial management process.
Yes, sir. I have joined, as a faculty in the year 1996. At that time, the Institute of Management in Government, which is called IMG. The IMG is owned by the Government of Kerala for giving training to government officers, including IAS officers, IPS officers, etc. It was there originally. And 96-97, they shifted to SH College, Devara, under the coordination of Reverend Father Savians. So, from 96 onwards, nearly 25 years of experience as a faculty for financial management. I have about 32 years of practice as a chartered accountant. So, my involvement in this program is once in 6 months. 6 days classes. Classes means counseling. Counseling is nothing but discussion and clarification and clearing their doubts. And the advantage of me is that practical experience for a long years with so many clients as corporate, non-corporate, business and charitable institutions, individuals, etc. So we are able to give maximum orientation on practical side rather than the theoretical area. So in addition to that, we are also helping them for preparing the project report. And we used to tell them to visit the industry and see how the industry is working. And we used to give them opportunity for undergoing training in our firm as well as other industries. Therefore, with regard to financial management, the number of students attending the program is totally encouraging. In the initial stages, during the year, before about 5 years back, the number of students attending the class was about 200 to 300 students in a huge auditorium. So, and over a period of time, the number of students get reduced. Now it is about 1,543 students in the year 2020. Out of that, nearly 20%, 30-35 students are regularly attending, and others are also conducting for clarification of doubts. Therefore, I am very happy to inform you that the orientation on financial management, as far as my area is concerned, they are very happy.
And our computer department, Department of Computer Science, okay, is a very
Placement also they are getting through various industries, and we are also helping them. We are collecting their biodata and
how many members?
How many? Maybe once in a year, four to five students are getting the opportunity through me, actually in the financial area, even in the and also we are providing the orientation to government officers. Our students are like a district collector, income tax officers, commissioners and senior teachers, more than age of 70, above 70 ages people are coming for programs.
What program they are from?
MBA.
MBA.
No, ordinary MBA. There is banking and finance. There is for banking professionals. And there is plain MBA, their management program. The management program not open for banking and finance people or entrance exam based. And we have the PG diplomas also now on offer for 1 year. That all also complicated. Because the entrance examination is there and only the quality or the qualified people get admitted into the management program. And as for the, if you are undergraduate, you have to have 3 years working experience. So this is for add-on qualification, and this qualification helped them to jump in their career also. And many come back for refund of fee by the institution where they are employed also. Once you pass IGNU MBA, some offices are honoring that qualification earned, and they get the fee refunded by the institution that they are employed.
Sponsor. Yes. Sponsor. So only my one question, but we have enough strength, but the day scholars are not benefiting more than that.
They are those who are attending the offices.
No, actually, sir, that also sir can talk about during the regular admission process.
Yes.
Sir, there is a promotional meeting held to the day scholar to join small programs, certificate programs like functional English, which will add value to their credentials earned from the regular college. Thereby, they increase the employability in the market, job market. That also sir facilitates.
As soon as assistant coordinator shall I explain some details of the activities of the then normally we conducted induction meeting March and September. Okay, along with this induction meeting, the concerned people, concerned people from the regional center, they explain about the course registration, it's a website online course registration and the exam registration that's also on online. And assignment submission at the college study center. These are details are given by the concerned people. And then we conducted the counseling class sessions, that means theory and practicals, and for the MCA, MBA, and BC, and the BC. Then January to May, and July to November. Normally, January to May means for RR students, pre registration students, and March to May actually for fresh students. And also same thing happening in the second session, that July to November. Then assignment evaluation and preparing award list. That means actually we sort out the assignment submitted by the students and other program wise and also course wise and distributed to the academy counselors. And then they will evaluate it and then return back to the study center. And then we will enter the marks online at the portal, using the portal. And conducting the exams. The theory exams will be conducted normally June and December, and the practical exam July and January. And the practical exam for BCA and the MCA, the computer lab, and the BSc, the concerned labs. Then attendance are recorded normally in the face to face classes, attendance are recorded in the pre-described format. That's all. And the mini project also, mini project, MCA, mini project, whole semester. That is evaluated by the academy counselors, and actually the project presentation by 50 marks and the by paper 25 marks. That's totally 75 marks. That's
it. Computer program has 2 projects. Mini project prepares the individual to face the main project, and there is decentralization of evaluation activity also. Mini project MCA 044 is evaluated at the LSC. And the real project MCSP 060 is evaluated at the headquarters, that's the regional center. And there can be the guide, and it is also a place for practical examination. And their role during this pandemic situation in conducting BSc practical and also BCA MCA practical is very much acknowledged and recognized at this juncture.
Any value additions?
Thank you.
value education.
One
is organic farming as such, it is there, and it is hobby as such. And the one, I don't know whether this plant is there, actually they have bone saw specialist in service doing as a hobby developed to the learners. So it looked like a flower was, but it is only, I think this is also bonsai with kept flowers. So this is various small plant and some add-on flowers are kept, that is also.
Ornamental fish also there. Yes.
So we are, we have a practice of bio-booking.
Bio-booking.
So this is the other one. Hmm. So instead of giving a what flower bouquet, we give a plant. Live plant in a small pot.
So every year in Hyderabad now they are giving tulsi plant.
Okay.
They make their own plants. That's what.
So the students are trained in that. So they like to buy the pots, the metal pots from the market, and they decorate it with paints and designs, and they have a ready area. Also, as Madam said, we have the organic farm, then a model 1 cent farm. 1 cent area is vacant, that is at the top of the principal's office. So all vegetables required for a family can be cultivated in that 1 cent. So the model farm is here, and also we have different types of farming. This aquaponics along with the aquaculture and vegetable farming, and also all weather cultivation on low structure there.
And so, also archaeological mods. So yeah. When they were building this building, whatever they located, they have kept it there for public viewing with special permission. And they also maintain the lake, the river, which is one of the part of this compound, as a contribution of education society to the public at large. That is also there.
Also, we try to clean the lake
every
week or once in a month by picking the plastic being dumped by the most of the land is set apart and is being made into compost. So, we'll after this, we'll just have a look on.
And personal counseling related to academic matters of how to pursue beyond what is done at SH College. And also certain life skills are also extended by the fathers here. Yeah.
Now we are constructing a very big rainwater harvest. A big area is set up for that.
Why that's big? It's a multi-purpose, it's an indoor stadium. Underground it will be rainwater harvesting, and before that we will be having volleyball court, basketball court, shuttle badminton, everything. It is not a construction, it's going on.
We have a look at that.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
When I place, I am very happy to place on record the sincere support from the regional center in all aspects. Especially during our this classes are going on. Once in a while, madam used to come to our labs and see how things are going on. It is not a, it's a complaint finding, but it's a positive support. And especially during this pandemic situation, very cordial. And because students are the stakeholders, we are very aware of that. And both, so there is a very good rapport between the regional center and the college.
So in one word, you said that you are student centered.
Students?
Can you give me a mobile number so that they can be in contact? one of the largest examination hall in Kerala.
For mainly for the exam purpose as well as then commonly.
Students will feel what a hydrophyte is, how it is floating, how they feel.
Yeah, yeah. So it is free floating, and it is called the lotus, see, water lotus, the shape and size. So students will be having that.
Skeleton of the elephant.
So the spider because that is you cannot get anywhere else.
Be careful, what is that?
My father, Gabir was the head of the other board. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go to the next one.
This fellow and this fellow submitted their PhD thesis. She also defended her thesis.
Why Bob?
Yeah, Vaibhav is over, and she also awarded a PhD. Vaibhav is over, and these are the four students under my guidance. This is Dr. Ms. Francis, this is her. And she and Dr. Francis got patent.
Oh,
congratulations.
Recently.
Like fundamental research.
No, yes, yes.
We'll be happy to have you.
Thank you.
Thank you. the adult department of primary. Yes.
And also IQAC coordinator.
I'm the IQAC coordinator of the college. We are in the process of accreditation for the college. This is the fourth cycle.
All
so,
the best.
Yeah, so we will be uploading very soon. Thank you, sir.
And digital programs are there in our library.
Okay. We have a digital library, and then we also have the InfraNet, and where we have the NList, and that is open to the students. We will give the password, and we have a G Suite, so our students are given the Gmail ID, using which the students can make us details. Then we also promote NBTEL and SWAYAM courses here. The college is a chapter of NBTEL, and we have students doing the courses, and just 1,000 rupees is the exam fee, that's the only fee. But in case a student doesn't have the money, the college will give the money. That's how we promote.
And we have the exchange program. That is the foreign students coming and yes, you have.
This is also in the international office.
International office also.
Looking after this okay. office too. Okay. So that is why temporarily we have shifted the NAC working area
to this
office.
Five foreign students are students here. Okay. And they are studying here. This is our picture
of this. This is the name.
Yes. This is the part of the library. And the students are allowed to.
Till 9 o'clock in the evening. So a lot of people will come and walk, especially aged people. Because there is nothing to fear about traffic. If you wish, you can have a walk.
Perfect. You can just have a lift from there.
Yeah, we saw the college. Not this one.
So including entertainment everything.
And in the evening the ambience is
different.
So a lot of people come and sit there, meditate, do exercise. Yeah, we'll walk this way.
Thank you.
value added.
Yeah, vehicle entry.
Can you open the door for me?
Sir, no. Sir,
pardon me. That is, their studies and sport.
they volunteer to pay the fee. And there is no benefit otherwise for them. It is their social commitment which is making them.
See, this year actually we have admitted to transcendence. That is also free of cost. Actually, we have paid, management have paid the fees.
But there, have you taken any criteria like merit, like some student got 70% and they go like that, or downgraded, or what criteria you have?
Economically,
we have. Socioeconomic.
You are only 2 years old. You are only 2 years old. Okay. That is only 2 years old. Still, they are only that is stage.
What do you mean? So, what is your current merit? Strength, weakness.
Strength of our institution is the infrastructure and the management.
Perfect. That's
right. And the management is inclusive, I should say. The socially inclusive and also gender-wise inclusive. And the best part is that they take to the society and they have a very good grasp of the society, especially in UBA.
We have specific type of courses like BSc Petrochemicals. BSc Petrochemicals is a rare course. It is the first course in India, right? In Petrochemicals. Also, we have a BO course in Sound Engineering. BO Sound Engineering. It's a degree course, 3-year degree course.
BO.
BO Sound Engineering. We have actually, today we had a presentation of principal presentation. So we have UGC careless journals about 49 careless journal publications under UGC careless journals. We have one research lab, multidisciplinary research lab. The three of our teachers are research guides in many institutions. Then we have three PG, MSc Physics, MSc Mathematics, then MCOM. Then 25% of the teachers are PhD holders. 25% of the teachers are PhD holders. Then 42% are MT holders in our institution. Then majority of the teachers are women. Like 85%, only 15% are gents.
But if the man is coming now, then PhD is the most important
criteria.
And you are now. Research papers like Scopus.
Actually,
now nobody bothers about ISSN and ISSN.
There is a careless journal, sir. Careless
only journal. Scopus.
Scopus is it's a careless journal. It's a careless group of journal. Group of category comes. Scopus comes in careless.
UGC careless.
I don't know.
We do conduct international seminars. We conduct national seminars. We have about 12 UG programs now. 12 UG programs, 3 PG programs. Many seminars, workshops being conducted.
So,
actually,
the security situation of this institution in college.
Actually, our college started in 1981. Actually, we have a patronage of alumni movement, which was started in Bangalore in 1970s. So, after that movement, many education institutions started across the country, and alumni education trust is one of the that type of trust in Kerala. And under this trust, about the 7 institutions are there in Kerala.
This is a Christian management college, but highly secular, not the principal is a Christian.
So I am a Christian.
And most of the teachers are.
I am a Christian and I am a woman now. Yes. So it's a symbolic representation.
And teachers also, sir. Very secular school, sir.
Yes. Symbolic representation, the lady Christian principal.
In a Muslim institution. Addition to your word, in our Hyderabad also, more than 50 colleges are Muslim minority colleges. Their 95% are Hindu students.
Here also, this is 250.
Water for
is used for curriculum delivery. Basically, we are using Moodle.
Every room that qualifies, 100%
of the classrooms by ICT enabled. Then this is a Wi-Fi campus. 100% Wi-Fi campus. Library books to the rural people, Kuttambura, tribal people. Actually, we have donated about 750 library books to the tribal people. Then our teachers do visit the tribal community and take classes. The community basically communicative English classes. Then we conducted many camps like blood donation camp, cancer detection camp, eye test camps, etc. Then during the COVID time, since our students were not having the digital device, what we did was that we have conducted a survey initially when the pandemic started and when the government asked us to start online classes. What we did a survey, and based on the survey we understood that many of our students were not having this digital equipment, so we have raised money and we have given the laptops, then the tab and mobile phones. That is a collective contribution from the teachers and regiment.
Can you tell something about the alumni management?
Pardon?
About the alumni management.
Alumni college started in 1981 by Alumni Education Trust. Actually, the trust has the patronage of alumni movement, started in Bangalore in 1970s by the great missionary Dr. Mumtaz Ahmad. So actually, LME Trust started in 1978 in Kochi. The LME College started in 1981. Under the LME Education Trust, we have about 6-7 institutions in Kerala. Actually, many other all over India, we have LME. We have many institutions under LME movement, like LME Medical Colleges in Bangalore, LME Engineering Colleges in Delhi. So many institutions are there. So this is only part of the great movement, LME movement.
Projector. Key is with that.
Counseling, because our counseling is held during the weekend.
students show
so we have a counseling
session.
Good
classroom.
Okay. Any class, every classroom there are ICT and everything.
This is a pure then. When that is on the system and the teachers can show movies.
Properly numbered, you can see that filing system important. Here. This is the 1450 files. If you want to see the tribal file, you can just 1920. Which year? 1920. Tribal. That's
okay.
Community extension file. Show the community extension file. 1920 or 1890. It's 1890, no? Community extension. Okay. This is the file. This is the file. Community extension file. This is how we prepared this. This is cut up bottles and the community extension. The fiber. Kuttambura library. This is the library we have set up in Kuttambura. So this is the
we also have
the portal we have taken is
that's
why. This is the file of 1920 community.
The COBA activity extension they help
actually
a lot.
Our we have UBA. We have got fund from UBA. We are a part of UBA. Actually, we have adopted four institutions,
four villages.
We have adopted, and we have conducted many extension activity in the four villages. Actually, he is coordinator of one of the villages.
And then we renovated one Anganwadi there, and also we.
And during the pandemic, we have given a training to prepare sanitizer for the people there.
And
so
also
people. Actually, the base words come from Sanskrit now.
Even
some part of the Marathi also like.
Actually, the coordinator and the joint coordinators belong to this. This is our English department. You can see the Varnish management is done on this. I don't think you can see any other, maybe less place with this type of staff.
Thank you.
plan, a new plan.
Thank you.